Did this ever happen with you that you schedule interviews and candidate says, I'm not available in the market? And did this ever happen to you that you schedule the interviews and the candidate accepts it, but that person do not show up to the interview, right? How frustrating this is and how embarrassing it is when it comes to a recruiter and a hiring manager. And every recruiter can relate to it. And now how we can avoid it. So now if you are trying to avoid that kind of circumstances, you need to remember that you cannot avoid it 100%, because this is what the industry is, that people sometimes show up, people sometimes doesn't show up. Okay, and now what is that we should be doing then? So your primary motto or objective should be how you are going to minimize that no shows happening with you. Last quarter, if you had 10 no-shows, then you should be working with how it is going to be 7 or 5. Okay, you cannot make it 0 all the time in your lifelong. Could be, there could be a quarter that you schedule 10 people and 10 people show up. There is no rocket science in there, or there is no thumb rule that, okay, this is what should happen, this is what should not happen. But as a recruiter, if you want to make more placement, you should be primarily focusing how you are going to minimize the no shows happening. So now here in this video, I'm going to explain you a process flow that has helped me, and at the same time it has been helping so many recruiters whom I taught. So now every company might have different processes. Now it is up to you how you are following it. All right, so it's all about, again, I'm telling you, right? So there is no thumb rule that you should follow something, you should not follow something. Then why you should be watching this video is you are going to understand the unconventional way of thinking. So when I used to work as a recruiter, when I was training recruiters, so my primary focus is to explain them how strategically you move forward, so that you could able to achieve things and minimize these kind of chaos. So first, when interview request comes in, what is that recruiter does? Recruiter contacts the candidate, correct? So now there are recruiters who gets overexcited when they get interviews, and you might be experiencing when the person gets an interview request, the whole body energy shifts, the behavior changes. Sometimes recruiters start talking in loud voice. Sometimes they talk so much with the candidate that they forgot to ask some main information. Or sometimes they try to give the candidate so much information that they'll like overexcite. So are you the similar kind of person who gets excited, overexcited, hyperexcited with in an interview request? Yeah, then the reason is you got to hold on. You got to hold your energies or behavior. You got to control yourself, okay? So why it is like that? Because whenever you are out of your control or you're out of the expectations, your excitement, the person that side feels as if there is something benefit for you, okay? So now as a recruiter, you got to understand that we are here not to get excited about interview request, but to feel happy if that person gets the job and, you know, makes money out of it and keeps their family happy. That is our job. So it is like, have you ever seen a doctor getting excited when the patients came in? No, they are normal and they feel happy if they're solving the health issues. The same way you need to connect here. Now, when I say interview request and contact, then why I'm saying you all this? Because before you even contact, you need to have that relationship established in such a manner that you should be knowing what is that happening with the candidate. Because most of the time what happens when you contact the candidate, you might be ending up knowing that the candidate is not in the market. Now, after an interview request comes in and you are going to let your hiring manager know that the candidate is not available, then the primary problem is that you are not understanding where exactly the candidate is, and you just forgot after submitting the candidate. That is the reason the candidate did not tell you where exactly the process is going on. So now, do all the candidates will tell what is that going on? It depends how the recruiter and candidate's relationship is, all right? For me, 90% of candidates used to tell if they have got a job and something like that. So 10%, there is always an imbalance in there, right? So you got to monitor that, how you are building your relationship. So generally, when interview request comes in, all of a sudden, recruiters start calling or messaging everywhere. So first, you got to understand that when you get an interview request, first send an email that there is something important came in and you want to connect with them, and let's schedule a time. Now, what happens there is the candidate is not aware of what exactly happened. So now when you send an email and schedule a call, then there is a possibility that you may ask, hey, John, what is that going on with you? I just wanted to understand if everything is the same as we have discussed last time or anything has changed. For example, your job search status, for interview status, your the rate, the salary that we have discussed, is this remaining same or anything changed? So now before you tell an interview request, you should be knowing about this information. When you send an email and set up a call, then you tell it, okay? I mean, if you send, hey, John, you have an interview request, can you reply back? There are high possibility that the person may reply or may not reply, okay? So it is suggested. Now, if something is working with you, just follow it. There is no problem. But I'm telling you how I used to do it. If you like it, you can follow it. No problem in there. All right. And now, I would prefer if you send email, get the connection. First, after sending email, wait for some time. Then you call, or after you set up an email, you got a confirmation that yes, that person can talk to you. Then call. After you call, what is that going to happen? When you initiate that, hey, you have an interview request, or you ask whether the candidate is in the market or not, or you might be asking that if that person is available on that time or not. So that person could be available, could not be available. So if the person is not available, what is that you're going to do? You are going to ask, are you not available for this time, or you would not be available at any point of time to take the interview? Could you please let me know what exactly going on in your side? So now if the person says, I'm not available in the specific time that your client wanted, then you may say, okay, then you can take the other timing, that is what works with the person, okay? Then you share that with your client and you reschedule it. Now this is the general thing, but what is that you can do is, before you taking the availability, before you reschedule it, so you can add some sort of strategy, that is create scarcity. What is scarcity is, you got to tell the candidate, you got to pitch in such a way that, John, you know what? There are other candidates are also scheduled 30 minutes after you call. You are the first person whom client wanted to talk and compare with other candidates. Now, if you do not take this interview, now what is that going to happen is, those other two people will definitely take the interviews, and now there are high possibility that the client may reschedule it or may not. What if the two other candidates the client likes and releases an offer? You may lose an opportunity. Now you got to decide whether this job is important for you, or something else that is there in this timing is important for you. Now, if you ask me, if I would be a candidate like you, if I would join, I would definitely stop everything and prepare for this interview, because when a recruiter says client has scheduled interview and set up time to discuss in whatever the job is about, and they kept my schedule on the top of everybody else, then I definitely feel proud about it, and I definitely want to present myself in such a way that I will stand out than other people whoever in the line. So now it is up to you how you would like to deal with it. And if you ask me, I would suggest the first one, that postpone everything what you have and focus on this one. Talk to the hiring manager and understand what they have, and explain how you are a better match, so that the person will be comparing with other people, and who knows, he may cancel other interviews and may just hire you, right? Anything can happen. So now let me know what we should do. So if you still think there's a genuine need, then you reschedule it. Now you're asking me, is it bluffing? It's not bluffing. It is about helping the candidate to make a decision. Okay, that is how you should look at. Now, if you the candidate is available, in the case of not available, I explained you the strategy. Now, the candidate is available now. What you would do? What is your objective here? You got to understand. And your objective should be get a confirmation on the timing and ensure that they attend it, correct? So this is what we are trying to mitigate. So once you get a confirmation on the timing, so what is that you should be doing after that? So don't just read job description or share it, but give insiders to close it as well. Meaning, don't just read the job description, whatever you have shared in the past. What you should be doing is, before this, in you know, confirming that, you should be talking to your manager or lead or to the hiring people to get some insiders, how the interview is going to be, what kind of person the hiring manager is, do you have any previous experience with the hiring manager, or you may ask the hiring manager, okay, what is that he should be looking in a candidate and so on. So that will help you to prepare the candidate in other level, just not that skills level, okay? So you need to explain that the candidate properly. And now you should not be explaining this all together, but what I would suggest is, okay, so you would set up a time, or let me check if the client can confirm, and after the confirmation I will come back and I'll give you something valuable. So I want you to answer my call. Is that okay with you? And this is what you should be asking, okay? Now, you do not say that, hey, I'm going to send an email with the interview prep information. There is a document attached. Go read it. And all the, you know, in interview prep, you might be sending. You dress formally. You comb yourself and, you know, trim yourself. Or business casual, business professional. You be positive. Talk this, talk that. Every company does that. And every candidate knows that. Alright, but there are how many candidates do you think they are going to read everything, all the pages, whatever you sent? Most of the time recruiters do not read, but how we expect the candidate to read all these PDF documents, something that your HR has prepared it, like, you know, very normal, generic, and you send it, and you send that for all the interview requests, assuming the candidate is going to read it. So no, you should not be doing that. So what is that you should be talking is, from the beginning till this time, what is that you as a recruiter observed that the candidate should include or should not include? Maybe the way they answer, maybe the way they approach to situation, maybe the way they handle things, maybe they, you know, the behavior changes when you ask some questions. So in that way, you are going to tell that, John, this is what I have observed in the last 4 or 5 days conversation, that you should be focusing on this. And that will definitely going to impact on the outcome of the interview. All right. Now, this is, I don't want to take you personally, but this as a recruiter, this is my suggestion, because I am in this industry since last 15 years. I do these things. Tens of people I schedule interviews in every week. So I know this thing well and how this client works. All right. So just keep this in your mind when you interact. So these are the kind of tips are helpful for the people. Now, ensuring the candidate attended, what would you do? First thing is, you got to clear objections that what could be possibly coming on their way that can stop them to take the interview. Now, these things should happen prior the interview request. Now, as a recruiter, how good your follow-up process, how tactically you are connecting with people, how strong you are building your influence and your authority and your control, that all boils down here. If you are someone just focused on the submission, then waited till the candidate gets an interview, then you started running behind this person, there are high possibility that those people may attend, may not. But these objections primarily should be taken off or cordoned before you or the person gets an interview. Okay, so now what could stop them to attend it? Now that should be your question. You may ask, John, we have confirmed the interview, right? So what could possibly stop you to attend the interview? Because I see there are candidates that they say yes, but they do not hey, there is my son is crying, okay, excuse me. So here, there could be possibly something comes in all of a sudden, okay, and the candidates do not answer my calls and they behave as if I'm a stranger. And that is really frustrating, and that jeopardizes my job and relationship with the client. So if you think anything that may come to you, or do you think this is something is going to happen with you? So this is the one of the way how you clear objection. And the candidate says, no problem. I'm definitely going to attend interview. And you are confirming once again that they are sure they are going to attend the interview. Okay. Now, after that, if you see that is a telephonic interview, then you need to ensure what contact number they are talking about. If it is, you know, telephonic, okay, confirm contact number. If the client is calling this candidate, or you go to share client's dial-in number, if anything is there, okay. And if this is a video interview, what is that you're going to do? You need to ensure that. Ensure candidate has a proper, you know, video link. So it could be Skype or Zoom or anything could be, okay. Now, after that, you got to ensure that there is a proper camera and mic is there. Now you got to test it. After you test it, what is that you should be doing? You are going to confirm the interview. So do not confirm the interview prior if there is something else. So you may give some tentative information to your client or manager that, hey, candidate is available. So now I'm just working on creating a Skype ID or Zoom ID and checking the camera mic is good or not. So at the meanwhile, if you want to confirm the client, confirm it, but I'll give a confirmation after I discuss properly. All right. Now, after all this, you can ask the candidate, since the interview is on so and so, do you want a reminder? So generally, I, as a recruiter, I remind. So don't mind me reminding or giving you any inputs that comes in these, you know, in this period of time from today to till you take the interview. Got it? They'll say, no, okay, no problem. You can call me back, or you can follow up. That's not a problem. You can send me a message or WhatsApp message, whatever it could be. So that is how you are going to close this when you got a, you when get interview request. So most of the recruiter, they just get excited. They call the candidate, they schedule it, and they send an email with all the schedules, numbers, names, everything with the interview prep email. And all of a sudden, candidate doesn't show up. So before that, you got to clear those objections. And if you are someone want to learn more, so you should enroll to the courses and where you will understand more about the strategies and techniques. All right. Thank you very much for watching. This is Suman Pachigula on a mission to impact 5 million lives. If you're a new subscriber, subscribe to this channel and be updated with other strategies and unconventional way of recruiting. Take care and God bless you people. Bye-bye.